Okay, we're going to be creating an image where we split the image into strips and swap them and muddle them up. So the first thing we need to do is work out what our image size is. I've got my ruler here. If you can't see your ruler, you can click on rulers in the view menu. It's also a good idea to have your history open, so make sure that you've clicked on your history just so you can undo things easily. And I need to check on the size of the image. I click on image, image size, and it tells me that this picture is 2000 by 2500 pixels. I want to split the width into 10, which is pretty easy. I need to do 200 pixels, and then I need the strips to be the height of the image to 2500. So if I click on my rectangular marquee tool, and it usually says normal to begin with, so I'm going to click on fixed size and type in 200 by 2500. And then I can just very easily make strips that are exactly the same size. I'm going to click layer via copy, and you can see a new layer has appeared. I'm going to click on the move tool, and I'm going to drag strip that I made over to the other side of the image, so we're kind of reversing the picture. I click back on background again, and then I want to make my next strip, and I want this one to be 1 after the last one. So if I line it up with the 15 line here, because I know that it was about 7.5 centimeters before, now I can line it up with 15. This is probably the most tricky bit, getting it lined up. And then I'm going to click layer via copy again, layer 2, go to the move tool and drag that over. And then I'm going to do the same thing again. So the last one ended at 15, so I start this one at 15. So for each picture, depending on the size, this is going to be different, and that's probably the trickiest thing to work out. Layer by copy, it says it's empty because I didn't click on background, so always make sure you go back and click on the correct layer. Move it along. Click on background again, make a new one. So this one needs to finish on 30. Right click, there my copy. It's still a very repetitive task. Click on background. So now we're getting to a point where we can't really see underneath, so what I can do to help myself out is hide the previous layers. So just did that one, so I want to end on 60. In that layer. Layers again. And there we go. So I need to make sure that I get my picture saved in the right place. So I'm going to go to File, Save As, and here I want to make it say JPEG. And I'm going to choose a folder to save it in, so it's in my OneDrive. To my OneDrive and find the picture. There it is. If I go to Teams and you can imagine that I'm going to my student folder and clicking on my name, I'm going to save mine into class materials. So all I need to do from this point is drag that into Teams and it will appear, and then students will be able to see it, and if we save that into a student folder, then I will be able to see it and the examiner will be able to see it, and that's the important thing. So I could take this a step further and muddle it up even more. So what I'm going to do is merge my layers. Click merge down, or I can do merge visible, and you can see now I've just got all of them in one background. So I go back to my marquee tool, and what I want to do is now make the width 2000 and the height 250, because we're going to do it the other way, so we end up with a checkerboard style image. So layer by copy. Move that to the bottom. Back onto the background. So now I want to line it up. little line just there so I can check where I was last. This is a bit trickier. So I'm going to go there. Keep going like that. It's really quite tricky to work out where to put it, so what I'm going to do is start at the top, and I know I've done three layers, so I'm going to make my new rectangle underneath that one by clicking on that bottom corner, and then I know that I'm lining this up correctly. There we go. Click on the background layer. And I'm going to keep going like that until I've completed the image. And there we go. You could even play around with rotating the canvas. See how that looks. I think I prefer it that way. So again, it's really important to remember to save it and then put it into your Teams folder.